విరళతః పరం
సర్వచింతనం విరళతః పరం
ఆజ్యధారయా శ్రోతసా సమం సరళచింతనం విరళతః పరం అగైన్ ఐ మస్ట్ రిపీట్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ లాట్ ఆఫ్ మ్యాథమెటికల్ ప్రెసిషన్ అండ్ లాజికల్ నీట్నెస్ ఇన్ ది ప్రోగ్రెషన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ థాట్స్ శ్రీ మహర్షి సేస్ ఇన్ ప్రాక్టీసెస్ వేర్ వి రిసైట్ సంథింగ్ వేర్ వి రిపీట్ ఎ మంత్ర ఎట్సెట్రా ఆర్ వి సింగ్ ఎ భజన్ ఇట్ కుడ్ బి ఆఫ్ సచ్ కైండ్స్ ఉత్తమస్తవ ది ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ ఇన్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్ సేస్ సింగింగ్ హిమ్స్ ఇన్ ప్రైజ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ అనదర్ కామెంటరీ సేస్ ది వర్డ్ ఉత్తమ హియర్ ఎస్పెషలీ రెఫర్స్ టు వేదిక్ ఛాంట్స్ ఉత్తమస్తవ యు నో ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ నో మెనీ హిమ్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫర్ శ్రీకృష్ణ బాలముకుందాష్టక కరారవిందేన పదారవిందం ముఖారవిందం వినివేశయంతం వటస్య పత్రస్య పుటేశయానం బాలం ముకుందం మనసా స్మరామి ఫర్ లార్డ్ శివ వి హ్యావ్ లింగాష్టకం బ్రహ్మమురారిసురార్చితలింగం నిర్మలభాషితశోభితలింగం జన్మజదుఃఖవినాశకలింగం తత్ప్రణమామి సదాశివ దే ఆర్ ఆల్ స్తవ బట్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది వేదాస్ సో ట్రెడిషనలీ దోస్ ఆఫ్ అస్ హూ హ్యావ్ బీన్ బ్లెస్డ్ టు లర్న్ సమ్ వేదిక్ హిమ్స్ హ్యావ్ యాక్సెస్ టు ఏ సుపీరియర్ టూల్ ఇఫ్ యు నో పురుష సూక్త ఇఫ్ యు నో రుద్ర చమకం ఆర్ ఇవన్ గాయత్రి మంత్ర ఆర్ ఇవన్ మృత్యుంజయ మంత్ర దే ఆర్ ఫ్రమ్ వేదాస్ సంథింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ వేదాస్ ట్రెడిషనలీ ఈస్ ఆఫ్ గ్రేటర్ కెపాసిటీ ఇట్స్ పోటెన్సీ ఇస్ మోర్ ఉత్తమస్తవాత్ సో వేదిక్ ఆర్ నాన్ వేదిక్ యు రిసైట్ అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ వాచిక అండ్ అప్లై యువర్ మైండ్ ఆల్సో అండ్ ఓవర్ దేర్ అగైన్ ఇనిషియలీ వెన్ యూ అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ లెట్ అస్ ఫేస్ ది ఫ్యాక్ట్స్ వి డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ది కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ దెన్ టు చాంట్ లౌడ్లీ brings a degree of concentration. When you chant loudly, then it's easier to concentrate. As you somehow gain greater concentration, you can go for manda. Uccha is the beginning, manda is the advanced level. Somebody who straight away tries manda, his intentions deserve all praise, but he will fail. He will not go far. His mind will go berserk and all kinds of thoughts will come to him. Sometimes you and I want to recite some stotra and there is some noise around. Have we all not experienced? We don't even remember the next line because of this distraction. Then we chant loudly. Even in the crowd a little, we mumble a bit loudly. Others are not disturbed. Then we get concentration. To say loudly is an aid because we say and we hear also. So uttama and then uccha, then manda, and as it advances there is no need to even recite mentally. It's as though it is going on its own. It's as though we are into it just mentally. And Maharshi says chitta jam japa, when japa goes from loud to soft to mental and subtler and softer within the mind with hardly any interruption, hardly any distraction, enriched further with love of God, then that, though it is vachika, we promote it, we call it dhyana itself. Dhyana and Chintana are the third level. But a practice of the second level is given the tribute of belonging to the third, the highest level. Sometimes in organization, somebody recognizing his or her, you know, distinguished service is given an honorary promotion. Somebody is, even in the armed forces, in civil organizations, sometimes, you know. Technically, that person has to acquire some more qualification maybe. But considering his distinguished service, in our India, there was Manekshaw, and he was given honorarily field marshal. And I have heard that to be called field marshal, it requires certain, you know, so many tanks and so many fighter jets and so many things have to be there. Perhaps the Indian Army, sheer number of soldiers, they would have very large. But maybe equipment and other things. So, Indian Army, I am given to understand, even today, cannot have a field marshal technically. You can go up to general, the pure full general. General also, you know, there is a major general, then there is a lieutenant general, major general, and then full-fledged general. That's about it. You can't have a field marshal unless the army has certain, you know, equipment and other criteria. But he was given when he offered and, you know, in certain wars, exemplary bravery and leadership and so on, that way. Other day I was at your downtown Fort Worth, and it is, though I have come so many times, I didn't know why the name Fort Worth came. Then we saw Brigadier General, certain general called Worth. So in honor of him, this place was initially called Camp Worth. Worth was the name of this general. And eventually it was changed to Fort Worth. I could connect to it. Back in India too, we have some places, Fort George, Fort this, Fort that. Some army people, some generals, etc., would have led a certain battle. So that was called Fort George or somewhere. So this is Fort Worth. So like that, japa technically is vachika karma, but it is given the status of chintana, dhyana, chitta jam japa, dhyana muttanam. Now talking about dhyana, seventh verse touches upon dhyana. In dhyana, we could have certain interrupted contemplation or uninterrupted contemplation. The uninterrupted flow, smooth flow, is rightly compared with the smooth flow of clarified butter, what we call ghee. Ajya, when you are pouring well melted ghee from one vessel to another, sometimes you yourself wonder, is it flowing or not? It looks like an, you know, unmoving a column. It's flowing, but you don't find any break. Whereas if you open a tap, generally ordinary taps, you know, the water comes out and you see some dispersion there. Here it's flow, the oil. Taila dhara, here ajya dhara is an example. A Swami of Ramakrishna Mission wrote some article once. He mathematically expressed it. When you and I have just begun our meditational practices, which itself is quite a way ahead, if thoughts of God were to be named G, and if thoughts of the world are to be named as W, thoughts of the world, money, pleasure, position, power, enjoyment, suffering, that's all world. He said, initially a meditator's flow of thoughts would be G, G, W, 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 G, then some W. So a lot of interruption of W. But as you and I advance, ji, ji, ji. Every thought is related to God. That is Srotasasamam. Two examples. One is the flow of clarified butter. Srotas is flow of a river. A river, think of those portions of certain rivers where it is so steady. In fact, some places you go and you wonder whether the river is flowing this way or that way, because of the wind, some waves seem to suggest the river is flowing maybe, you know, west to east, but actually the river is flowing east to west. Ganga in Varanasi sometimes misleads us. I have explained to many visitors when they used to come and see me, they would say it's going this way, right? And I, with knowledge of geography and other things, no, 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 it's flowing that way. It came from, you know, south at Varanasi, that segment is somewhat south to north. So, but it looks like so steady. We don't even know what direction. It's a body of water with no break. Srotas. Srotas is river. Now, these are two analogies. The theme proper is contemplation on God, contemplation on Krishna, suppose. As you begin with Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, you use the mantra to connect with God. And as the connection with God gets more and more firm, then there is a steady flow of loving relationship, loving thoughts towards God. Initially, we have begun with so much distraction, but as we move further, we are so united, all the time united. Now here, being an Advaitin, being a non-dual master, Maharshi Ramana takes this topic of meditation to an even greater height. He says, if you look up, look at it, if you think of it, this meditation could have a sense of division. God and you initially are separate. And as you get going, you will find this division is a mischief of thought. God and I and God are one whole, one undivided truth. He mentions it in the next two shlokas. Bheda bhavanat sohamityasau.
Bheda bhavanat sohamityasau.
Bhavana bhida pavani mata.
Bhavana bhida pavani mata.
Bheda bhavanat sohamityasau.
Bheda bhavanat.
Bhavanabhida pavani mata.
Bhavanabhida pavani mata.
Bhava shunya sad bhava sustitihi.
Bhava shunya sad bhava sustitihi.
Bhavana bala bhakti ruttama.
Bhavana bala bhakti ruttama.
Bhava shunya sad bhava sustitihi.
Bhava shunya sad bhava sustitihi.
Bhavana bala bhakti ruttama.
Bhavana bala bhakti ruttama.
The bhakti yogi may not go for elaborate study of Vedanta or such literature. But essentially, somewhere, some guru, some guide, somebody will give him the input. You know, really God and you are no different. Contemplate on soham, saha aham. That supreme truth is the spiritual essence in me too. As the body and mind, you and I can never be God. But the Vedanta's stand is, we are not the body and mind. We are certain Chaitanya Tattva, and this body idea, though looks so real, is an appearance only. Stephen Covey, the author of a management book, Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, said in a conference, I believe, in San Diego, I am convinced, he said, that we are not human beings aspiring for a spiritual experience. I am convinced that we are spiritual beings presently going through a human experience. We are essentially spiritual beings. He had studied some Eastern philosophy too. So, Soham Advaita Vedanta, for which Ramana Maharshi was a living example in his time, says that this mind of ours can go to such heights of purification, and then a certain quantum leap, certain fundamental change takes place in our outlook. Call it like a metamorphosis, like that larva becoming a flying butterfly. Who can think